Hello and welcome to our Wudang online academy class. Today we start with the achievement trend form. Many students cannot visit us in our school, so they remain at home. This class is aimed for the local students and the online students who want to follow our exercises at home. The achievement trend form is the basic exercise that is required when you're starting with the Wudang practice. The practice consists naturally of the Qigong, Tai Chi, and Gong Fu. We don't separate those three, yes? And you will find many synergies in the Qigong form that are required for people who are just starting at a Wudang school, okay? So we will start now with the opening. I will show you from many different angles. I try to follow the movement and practice it frequently, all right? So let's look at the form. So usually when we start with the 𝕘𝕖𝕖 form, the shufu or shishong will say 𝕘𝕖𝕖. This will apply that you should prepare for the upcoming form. So you should be in attention. Then we have the 预备. The shufu or shishong will say 预备. This means we're starting the form. 预备 itself usually means to be in attention. But the attention position in the 𝕘𝕖𝕖 is mabu. During the mabu, yes, we protect with the hands the kidney, which is very important. Yes? So often when we have new students, they have their arms somewhere around here or somewhere around here, raising the shoulder. Be careful. Why we do this posture? This part, the kidney part, is very soft. It's no matter how much we exercise, this part is always our weak spot. So people can always attack here, okay? So when we go into mabu, we protect the soft part, yes? So this is why when we say 𝕘𝕖𝕖, we go into 预备, we here protect. Relax the shoulders, do not raise it, yes? But keep the hands tucked into the hip, yes? Here, okay? So now we start with the movement. When we have the command, 预备, we should fall into posture, yes? So basically we just raise the knee and we fall into it. The hands over cross and we go protect, yeah, protect. Now when we're punching, we shouldn't only punch like this, yeah? We should punch with the gravity center, so we're turning, yeah? Then you can hear the punch, yes? So the first two punches are right and left. Yeah. R. Then we block, yes? Here, block. Change combo. Then you open the hip and we block. You push outside, okay? Look, here, yeah? In the combo posture, often the students punch like this. The purpose of the combo is to reach far. So punch like this, then change side, push the block, change mabu, and punch combo other side, long punch. Okay? Try follow my movement, I'll show you from another angle. 𝕘𝕖𝕖, 预备, 一, 二, 三, 四, and we're here, okay? I want to show you from the side. 𝕘𝕖𝕖, 预备, 一, 二, 三, 四, and relax. Okay? Please keep following this sequence 20 times. In the next scene, we do it 𝕘𝕖𝕖, continuously. 𝕘𝕖𝕖, 𝕘𝕖𝕖. 预备, 走. And relax. Let's try it again from the other side. 𝕘𝕖𝕖, 𝕘𝕖𝕖. 预备, 走. And relax. All right? Try, practice this four-punch combo till you can do the 𝕘𝕖𝕖. And then we go over to the next section. The following section looks like this. So after we finish the first one, yes? One, two, three, 4. We change into knee up and look here, yes? Watch me from the side, yes? So when we finish the gombo, you turn, yeah? Upper body turn, you raise the knee and you look here and you try to stay calm. How to stay calm in this posture? You push the shoulder down to the ground and the standing knee push up. This way, you can stay quiet inside, okay? So it is very important that you find your point where you focus the curvature center very fast. You know, you don't have much time. You are at the gombo and turn, then you're here, and then you change, you step forward, okay? So let's do this movement slowly, step by step. So when we finish the four punch combo, we are at the gombo posture, okay? Upper body turning, the knee go up, hand close, the right hand closing, the right hand on top of the left hand, and you look. Okay, look here, the posture. Here, closing, look. And then you're here, all right? So when we are in this posture, first we step. We step 90 degrees, you can see here. And then we turn the hip and stand here. Push the hands outside, yeah? They fall here. Yeah, yeah. One. Go, yes. Now change the left leg, step into the right. The hands protect and you punch. Yes. The right hand is punching and you stay into xiebu. The knee don't touch the ground. The xiebu is the resting posture. You should sit on the heel you see here. You sit on the heel and try to rest. The upper body is slightly forward and you're punching. Okay? These postures are important. Try to make them as clean as possible. So, again, one more time. Gombo, change, knee up, look, step, yeah? Here, step 90 degrees, the hands open, yeah? Relax the shoulder, here, one, open, step, go down, xiebu, punch. Then you turn like this and step close with the outer leg. I will show you the sequence again from the other angle, which usually are seen by my students. So we finish it here, okay? Gombo. So, look, step, go, punch. As you see, we use the Tai Chi principle. All movements start and finish at the same time. So the punch and the posture finish, okay? Same time. This is very important. Try to coordinate these movements and the transitions between the postures. 7-2. 预备. Okay, so now let's do the other side, okay? First, we were doing it from here. And you go, you step, xiebu, and then the outer leg, step close. Now we're starting here again. We're doing the same movement at the other side. Watch closely. Hand and feet come from outside to the inside. Block. Yes? Relax. Then fall into posture. Watch from the side. Hands and leg come from the outside. You block inside. And then fall, protect, and go into posture. You're protecting here, okay? So, the same movement, now with the punch. Watch closely. So. Okay. Gombo, try punch as wide as possible. Now from here, step. Go here, look. Yes, same but other side. Step, 90 degree. Hands open. Mabu, xiebu, punch, Outer hand punches. Upper body, rest on the knee. Rest on the heel in Shiatsu posture. And turn. And the outer leg, step close again. And we are again at this posture, okay? So now let's do the full sequence from the same perspective. My students can see it. 7圈, 预备, 走, All right. Let me show you from the front one more time. 7圈, 预备, This was the first sequence of the 7圈 form. Don't stop improving and always try to ask yourself how to improve these postures. All these basic postures, you can try to stay more calm, you can try to stay more lower, and how you combine the transition between the postures. This is your 7圈 practice. So when you follow now this video and you like this class, you want to start in a Wudang school, practice the 7圈 frequently and you will have it easy with all the other forms. All right, thank you for watching. If you have questions or you want to leave feedback, there is the comment section below. Otherwise, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching and see you soon for more. Goodbye.